And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Gonna go look for a wolf. Oh, we're sneaking? Nah. Here we go. Oh, wait, what? Oh! How do we miss this guy? I thought we'd been everywhere. Could they have randomly occurring monsters? Oh, we're getting hurt. What do we have equipped? Okay, we all have melee weapons, and I've commanded them to attack. Maybe Dern should heal himself, though. Gotta heal anyway. I'll lay hands. Okay. Got another one of their livers. So delicious, how can we pass it up? Alright. Once again. I thought I had fast mode on. Here we go. Somehow we must have missed that one. Fast mode off.
Quickly and quietly.
Sneak mode on. Entree. Okay. Bones of the fallen and devoured. Hello. Oh. Some of you walk upright. Standing tall amongst the wolves inhabiting the cavern, this creature turns to face you as you venture forward. Scores of wounds and scars riddle its hide, and one dull eye stares out blindly from its skull. It growls a threat as you approach, one echoed by its fellows. With our lore ability or skill attribute, whatever, you know that this half-wolf for the spirit-shifted form of a druid, though you see no gleam of Kith intelligence within its gaze. At the creature's feet lie two villagers, one heavily wounded, the other holds an arm across his stomach, and he looks up at you with pleading in his eyes. Well, we gotta help that guy.
Help! Please help us!
My thoughts exactly. As the beast turns its head back towards the hunter, you sense a strange aura emanating from it. It is as if its hide were holding in a tempest of soul essence, fierce and all-consuming as flame. Can I reach out for the beast's soul and then try to talk to it? It takes little effort before the beast's soul threatens to overwhelm you with its intensity. Wrath and hunger buffet you on all sides until you reach through the storm to find a smaller, dimmer pulse of light, and are swept headlong into a memory. The chill bites into your cheeks, and your lungs burn a little from the run. You look down at the little wooden carving in your hand and run your thumb along the edge of the carved bear's spine. The totem has already brought you luck. You've found two rabbits in as many snares, and that's a rare enough feat these days. You're certain now that this was a gift from Galloween, that you were meant to find it on that lonely shrine and take it.
Soldier!
Your father's voice snaps you out of your reflections, and you rush forward to rejoin him beside the campfire. You brandish the hairs and catch a glimpse of a rare smile under his graying beard. But the smile disappears almost immediately as a shadow falls over you both. You feel the rush of wind a moment before the log comes crashing down and roll out of the way just in time. You hear your father cry out in pain somewhere nearby. Both the hairs and the totem slip from your grasp. You can feel power surging within you. Your heart thunders in your chest, but instinct pulls your senses into order, and you feel the familiar stretch of limbs, the sudden, dizzying shift in height. But something is wrong. Your senses are fading, rather than growing stronger. There's a howling in your head, like a screaming chorus, and everything in you shrieks for you to bite, to tear, to eat. The memory slips from you, and when you come back to yourself, the beast is shaking its head as if to clear an itch, clawing at its ears. Soldren! The creature snaps and snarls, evidently uncomprehending. It edges toward the nearest hunter, as it watches you balefully with its single eye. Well, we can't back away. We gotta rush forward to help these guys. The beast turns from its wounded prey to face you, lunging forward with claws outstretched. Okie dokie. I have tracked the wolf to its lair, and must now confront it within. The wolf I found in the cavern bears more resemblance to a spirit shifter, though it appears incapable of communicating. My watcher ability has granted me a vision from what appears to have been the druid's past. In the vision, a young man took a totem from a shrine of Galloween. His subsequent attempts to shift into his druid form seem to have resulted in his becoming trapped in that other skin. Perhaps the totem has something to do with all this. It may still be at the old campsite where it was dropped. This is why I read this, guys. This is why I read this. It gives you better insight as to, you know, what you actually saw in the game. Okay, so we got a winter wolf, and we got a druid wolf. Weren't there like... I thought there was two winter wolves in this guy. Oh well, first of all, start off with Holy Radiance, like I like to do. Let's see if a dare can knock down the druid wolf. I'll send Canada to knock down the winter wolf. Pelagina can head for that as well. Concussive missiles, boom. And disintegration, boom. Oh, there is a bunch, okay. Alright, stop trying to hit everybody and hit this one then. The druid wolf is like almost dead already. Huh. Okay, out of focus. Let's just hit the wolf on you then. Help her out a little bit. Actually, it's almost dead. Okay. He's still alive, so let's pump him full of another missile here. Mind blades. On this one. Take this opportunity for a blessing. Espiritus Sancti. Chop him up. Everyone else can hit this one. And now everyone can hit this one, because Canada's getting messed up. Bad at all. The wolf that Thiersch hunted was more than a mere beast. It was a druid, so wholly consumed by his animal spirit that he could no longer engage rationally with Keth. He gave me little chance but to slay him. Thiersch may appreciate an update on the situation. We're completely willing to give it. Okay, we got wolf hide. More wolf hide. Wounded guy. Okay, let's see to him. Bless you, stranger. We'll make our way back to the village. I thought we were done for. Sure you don't need some healing or something?
Got it.
What's this? Potion of Major Regeneration. And a bunch of stalwart bony. It was a delay with the menu opening up. Alright. We should sneak just to find hidden stuff. Stop shushing me. Oh, dead body? Yep, skeleton. Ooh. Kurok's brand. 67 gold. That's a wand. 10% chance to cast combusting wounds on hit or critical hit. Well, then just say on hit. Grants fireball once per rest. Kurok was an Adirin noble in Red Saris who owned 600 acres of Vorlas fields. He considered himself a pious man, and his neighbors and tenant farmers knew him for his fervent devotion to Wurica. He labored alongside his tenants and kept meticulous records of production and sales, yet he was also known for his pitiless temper and his ruthlessness with shirkers. He carried a switch with him and would savagely thrash any worker he caught dawdling or lagging. Yet he was a favorite of the Imperial Governor, and so his excesses went overlooked. One day, Widwin approached him while he was doling out an especially savage beating. Widwin, fresh from his encounter with Aeothas, demanded that Kurok release his victim. When the Lord refused, Widwin asked what the tenant farmer had done to deserve such treatment. "He neglects his duties in the field," Kurok replied. "Every day he gathers less, yet still he enjoys the protection of my estate. Is it any wonder that your harsh treatment of this man would render him unable to fulfill his duties? Let him enjoy a week of rest. He will return to your service renewed," said Widwin. Kurok sneered. "You would reward his indolence. It is my right and my responsibility to discipline him for his errors." "What authority gave you such power over this man?" Widwin asked. "Wurica, the Oathbinder. It is she who set me above the farmer as his lord and employer, and her order that I serve in disciplining him." But Widwin persisted. "Does not the quiet winter beget the fruitful spring? It is by Aerithus's clemency that we enjoy rebirth in each new life and restoration with each morning, and it is Aerithus's season that blesses your fields. I say to you again, release this man." In his fury, Kurok turned on Widwin, his switch raised to strike, yet the rod grew suddenly hot in his hand. He cried out, and as he held the rod, it ignited. The flame that gushed forth blinded him instantly, scarring his face in the manner of the burned queen. Kurok dropped the smoldering rod and fled to tell the governor of what he had witnessed. Well, I'm glad he's never going to witness anything ever again. Some hot chocolate. Let's compare it with what he has. Guess that's that. I can't walk on this stuff. The rod versus the wand. Well, definitely doesn't damage anywhere near as much. I guess rods definitely do more damage. Yeah, I'm gonna keep the rod. Spare the rod. Get rid of the wand. Doesn't have a very good legacy anyway. I would actually heal these guys fully if I was able to. Okay. The only other place to look at here is these caverns. Unless we're leaving for Durgan's battery, we're not doing that yet. I'm actually going to save that for last. Da-da-da. Really like the music this time. I just don't like the combat music. I forget, was the combat... I didn't notice the combat music. I like the two themes from the original game much more than what they have here going on in the expansion. Actually, this is really stupid, but pretend we slept outside.
There's no accounting for taste.
No, huh? The petrified skull is as cold and hard as stone. Wax tears dribble from the eye sockets. Oh, I see they got candles in there. I'm also not sure why I'm having trouble pronouncing words tonight. It is most vexing. Let's go this way. Ah! Something over there.
Ooh.
What?
Ooh.
He's like, ooh. That guy.
Hmm? That's settled.
And is this settled?
That's settled.
Good.
No problem.
In here, nothing. The clapping. What is this? Oh, cave coral. Huh. Don't overcook it, one of these. Oh, Crag Ogre Cannoneer says. We got two cannoneers and an ogre. You mean stop before it turns black? I'm so lucky I need you to tell me these things, something like that. Where'd they go? Oh. That was weird. Okay, I guess we're just attacking them. It's probably gonna be a really tough battle.
Yes?
Thank you. Doop, doop, doop. Chain lightning. Centuration. Holy radiance.
Love.
Next.
Now, what the flames?
I'm healing here.
What? Moeth Ixi.
Okay, since neither of you guys are doing anything, attack. Give up now while you still can. It's pretty easy. Ogre blood. Potion of fleet feet. The inside of this minecart is caked with blackened grease. It smells of burnt fat. They're using a minecart to cook things? Pretty inventive.
I'll see what I can find.
Got it.
Through the doorway or this way? I guess this way, I don't know. These people, they've eaten. Oh, there's a Crag Ogre Chanter. How did he miss this fight?
Following your lead. Following your lead.
That's it!
Oh, here's another guy. Skeleton time. He probably won't survive for it. Oh, there they are. Cool. What about being surrounded by skeletons?
If we need to go down, take them all with us!
Ooh, what was that? What was that? Was that the skeletons leaving? Because I don't think I've ever noticed that before. A crack in the earth, almost. And who yelled that out? Two garnets. We got two opals out of the mix.
Laying low.
Got it.
There might be more nearby. These guys don't seem to notice their own fights. There's some goodies over here. Greatly enjoying this expansion so far, I must say. Sugar? Cheese! Hey, everything's better with cheese. Let's take this tunnel. was this hole? A wide shaft snakes deep underground. The lip is surrounded by scattered refuse and half-gnawed carcasses, but wisps of light wink along the walls below. Yet the chute disappears into darkness. Peering into the depths, all you can see are shattered bones and streaks of frozen sludge stuck in the ice. A rancid odor of rotted meat wafts from the chute. Spectre surroundings. I'm not going down yet. I gotta explore this floor. The ice that varnishes the chute feels slick and smooth. It won't offer any traction. The faint echoes from the depths suggest that it's a long way down. However, you notice a thick stalagmite nearby. It looks sturdy enough to hold a rope and grappling hook. Let's leave that for now. Back to sneak.
Quickly and quietly.
Ice chute. Okay. Alright, we'll go through this doorway. What's all that? Goes up to lower cavern. It's showing me the stairs up icon though. So I'm not sure what's going on there. Once again, I am going to explore this floor first. So let's go here.
I shall be discreet.
In here. More cave coral. Oh, here's a winter wolf. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. Except they're usually in packs.
Following your lead.
Oh, there's a guy. Crag ogre.
Gotcha!
Killed the wolf already. Takes care of that. That's your pet. You're next, buddy. Chain lightning. About disintegrate on intruder on that guy. Ooh, knock him right down. Knock him down to there. There you go. Owies. Still casting your thing? Yeah. Say one more time for this. Chain lightning. Didn't do anything? Run forward. Clear out. I can only hit these two. Having trouble keeping up with Pelagina's wounds somehow. Mind blades. I don't use that very often. Yeah, knock this guy down. Who's this? Pelagina? Sure, hit him. Where's a dare? Oh. Hit that guy. Healer again. Out of focus. Hit somebody. Right there, boom, fireball. Hi, Bunky. What are your wolves waiting for? Maybe they don't like you very much. Do you abuse them? Don't abuse animals. Now they're gonna attack.
No problem.
No problem, she says. Oh my god. Pause. Oh, she's out. My god. What's a dare doing over here? Hit that.
Yes.
Well, that's. Yeah, it's a dare. We're not doing anything? Attack. I can't believe Theodos got killed so easily. I feel much better now. We'll probably camp in here. Potion of Eldritch Aim. Ogre Blood. Copper. And hide.
Indeed. Bomb.
Indeed. Gotta explore the rest of this. We're gonna sneak.
I shall be discreet.
So we can find whatever secrets may lurk within. I think we may have cleared out this level.
That's settled.
Unlocked. Exceptional medium shield. A topaz. 23 golden obols. Nice. Spirits and oil. A sexy combination. Mm-hmm. Oh, what's this? There's a cannibal-shaped dent in the front of this shield. Oh, I wonder how that happened.
A simple test.
It looks like we can just break it open with our sword. Exceptional blunderbuss. Alright. Well, I know we're running a little late here, but let's see if we can finish off this floor. Let's rest. And go this way. Could you imagine if to rest in-game you had to actually sit around for 8 hours? Just leave your computer on and let it do its thing. That's the whole first floor, huh? Not a lot of ogres to be had. Alright, guys. The ground level floor of the Flames-That-Whisper Upper Cavern. It's like it continues into there, isn't that weird? Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time. Stay tuned for next episode when we go to the lower cavern. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.